Hello everyone, welcome to Bargain Gaming, where we can play excellent games without busting our wallets. This is episode 7 of Dishonored 2. Excuse me, sorry about that. Dishonored 2. We're trying to get to the other side, right? Through this hole we get to the other side. No. This is the other side. Sorry. This is the other side. Okay. I forgot that we came down here and this is the door to the next area here. Oh, there's another gun. Okay.
I'm being hunted by half the people in the Empire. Part of me is excited about what happens if they find me.
Excited? I don't know about that. Why are you excited? Okay, that's... Okay, we almost missed that one. Oh, okay. I read on the nets that there is a... That there is a treasure beneath the buoy. Remember in the previous episode I was trying to look for it but I couldn't find it? And it's supposed to be under the buoy. And we missed this one too. Okay, so... I get the crouching always mixed up. So that's a problem when I just played when we just finished playing a Deus Ex. And so its key for crouching was pushing down on R3. Okay, so let's just keep our stuff. We're not here to threaten anybody.
What are you covering your face for?
Okay, here is where the merchant is. Okay, let me. So supposedly under that buoy over there. Okay, let's swim out to it and let's see what kind of treasure there is. Forgot to set the timer. Okay, where is that boat? Okay, right here. Yes, what are these? Spring razor, grenades. Whoa. I forgot we need to breathe. Okay, back down. What are these? Sticky grenade, sleep darts. Oh, we got lots of sleep darts. Sleep darts. Okay, go back up. Okay, let's get some air. Okay, now I'll get back to, so we know that there are sleep darts there, so we can be more, I think, profligate about using sleep darts. Come on, get up there. Okay. Now let us, let's get back to...
In the Duke's absence, I have the following announcement. This year's mudfly concern is the most severe in recent memory. If you encounter a nest or an infested corpse, do not disturb it.
Okay.
Any attempts to practice the funeral rites of the Abbey of the Everyman...
Where is the door we came in through? This is the... Yes. Ooh. Oh, that's the guy. That's the body we dumped on the street. Okay, let's go through the... Now that we have a bunch of sleep darts, let's see if we can put people to sleep... rather than... Where is that hole? Here. Okay.
Oh, if only something would happen around here.
You know what? The it might be a good idea to our powers. This one allows us to see see what the other guys are seeing. How about let's have this one. Yes. Okay, let's test this.
Where did you disappear to?
Huh?
What?
It was coming from here. Let's see.
Come on. Good thing we were still looking at that map. Oh, at our, like this. Let's put this one here. No, let's put this one here first. Let's see what happens.
Maybe I should just work a double shift.
Okay.
So I don't have to listen.
Okay,
to
that guy's still looking really down there, right? So is that how it works? Yeah. Yeah. Okay, let's carry him. Loot this guy, loot this guy. Looks like there's some loot over here too. Oh, grenade. And bullets. Okay, we got three guys down. And, wow. So, again, let's try to see what this is. So that guy apparently is sleeping, right? So do we want to wake him? No. Do we want to put him to sleep? Okay, let's put everybody here. So we were going with lethal force earlier in our first part. So it might be a good idea to just checkpoint enforced. Let's see what's on this side. Nobody, right? Nothing. Maybe if we bring them all over on this side, people won't see them. The other thing we can do is actually release. See, in this trash can, there are blood flies. So if we release those, I think that's one way of getting them distracted or start running away from. Okay, and then for our guns. Okay. Once we get into trouble, we will use our guns. We won't be shy about killing these guys. Like this. Or like this. And this one is actually very good because this makes us the ability to jump. Makes it forces us to think in three dimensions. So that we can up, down, like on the other side, there are a number of balconies on the other side. Whereas on our side, there's nothing, right? There's almost nothing except for that balcony we came down from. So we can get to the other side, get to the balcony. Oh, that's an open door right there. Yes, we can do that. Right up there. Okay. While we're moving these guys. Because if I throw these guys, it will make some sound, and I'd prefer not to make any sound. So what we can do is get, let's say, assuming we can get rid of all the guards, put them to sleep, and if we have to kill them so that... And then we can now slowly explore all the charms and runes that this area has. Okay, let me do a quick save so that okay, not that one. Let's do a quick save on this one. Here we came in through here, right? Yeah. And then let's see if we can go to the other side by just flashing up to the stairs. Whoa, we almost didn't make it. Oh, they're still here. All of them. Oh, we're maxed out on this. Coins with the mire. Is this a report? Nope. Not a report. Wow, these guys were killed by nothing. Is this a report? 14th, that fool bringing his wife in with such an advanced case of blood fly fever. Okay. Flask carry. How about this on top? Are they? No. Okay, we need to go back into a crouch. So we're across the street. Wow, that's too far to jump, right? Getting to the other side. I mean... No. Let's not do that. Jeez. Hope there's somebody below us. That is nice. Then we do this. Whoa, this is a good combination.
We will burn a bright fire with our virtuous actions so the others will not lose their way.
There's only one way to say it's Abby. Never mattered.
There is a tale, a decade and a half old. A tale most often shared from overseers.
You can put them, this guy in here? Nice combination. What is on this other side?
Discipline to the muddiest ditch of disgrace. That is his tale. To once wear the cloth of the high overseer, and to later bear the heretic's brand across the flesh of his face. How did this come to pass, brothers and sisters?
Oops, somebody there? Strictures,
and you will know. A girl came to me on the 14th day of the month of harvest. I will never forget her words. From the mind and body, she looked up at me and asked what shrines could be found across the aisles. She affected a look of innocence, but beneath it I saw guile. My suspicions rose at once, and I questioned her sharply. Until she confessed to playing alone in an empty woodcarver shop at the edge of town.
Almost.
Each day for a week, she crept back to that place. And there in the cellar, she found cloth of purple and red, suspended from the walls,
okay.
And a wretched altar of candles burned low. Small trinkets of bone, and a few corners left by those within the outsider's wicked cabal. Those cursed figures who hunch and shamble just outside the lights of our city, whose faces we do not recognize, and whose voices are strange to us. The girl was taken from her home the next night, locked in a cage of iron, and toppled into the canal. Her corruption was eradicated. For the safety of all those who lived around her, all of you, we hardened ourselves to the cries of the apostate, to the heretic.
Wow.
And in doing so, we saved countless others from the horrible discord that awaits them beyond death. Karnaca is in great peril, brothers and sisters. Now, this is not news to those of you living through these times of crisis. But the source of your suffering might not be plain to you.
What's that?
Karnaca.
Okay.
Has turned away from the Abbey of the Everyman.
A stream of untruth.
Who's leading the city echoes would gamble with all that.
Sometimes I wonder if it would be better to crack the music boxes at each enclave. Pushed away. Here in the city, instead, there may be a few locations kept
the time of the great burning.
It seems dangerous.
Has but one
far worse. Mollygic construction materials scattered across the aisles. The metals used to make the devices are unusually rare. The techniques, if applied by anyone but the most faithful, resolute overseers,
border on heresy. Let not the wanderer into your home, friends.
I suppose you're
avoid
correct.
The stranger.
It grieves me to imagine what cultists might accomplish
the bedrock of
if they
the
took the music boxes and perverted them to their own end.
Whoa, this is really, really scary.
Assemble them in secret and dispatch them across the empire where they're needed to fight against the supernatural.
Seven strictures themselves. A wanderer is a friend to the outsider. Never doubt that.
Whoa! Where's the other guy? Where is the other guy?
Set a table for your family.
Put him inside here. By high, oh, ooh. So these are overseers, huh?
Insider himself. Hold closest to the seven strictures. If it is true that a witch now sits on the throne in Dunwall, and that the Duke of Cirkenus is in her thrall,
no.
Across the empire, do not doubt. We will verify this claim, and we will act. Smoke
Whoa.
Will billow. Fires will lick the stones of Dunwall Tower, and at the end of it all, the Abbey will stand. In
the huh. Reports from the Oracle. Okay, close. Man, I'm barely breathing here. Okay, what is this? What is this? How do we do this? That's 993 0. Ooh, what was that again? 0, then 5, then 3. Fantastic. Yes. So middle first is 0, brought it to 3. And then the left side, bring it to 5. And then the right side, I think just one by one, it opened up. Let's see what's here. Nothing here. Let's loot this place. Oh, this is whale oil, I think. Yes. What's this? Remember the 7. Okay. Excerpt from a longer work, the ancient music. Cash register open. Oh, cash register. Nothing. about here? Anything? Whiskey tumbler. On the Oracular Order by Douglas, whatever that historian's name is. Okay, I think this would be a good place to cut this episode. Thank you very much for joining me in this episode. Please join me in the next episode. Bye.